You know, you would think that the idea of being surprised by an allegation of sexual misconduct with someone famous, you shouldn't be surprised anymore. But this one's kind of surprising. Rap star, hip-hop mogul Sean Diddy Combs, right? He's been hit with a spate of lawsuits recently about his alleged conduct. But this one, the fifth one, is unlike any of the others. This is from a man, a male music producer named Rodney Jones. Now, his allegation is Combs forced him to solicit sex workers and underage girls for sex. Okay. But also drugged him, sexually assaulted him, and groomed him to have sex with other men. And there are other, a lot of salacious accusations too. But there are also some concerns about the accusations. Combs denies all. So let's take a look at it, all right? Here to break it down, trial attorney, legal analyst, Misty Marris, and one of Combs' former defense attorneys, Mark Geragos. Good to have you both. So, Misty, what do people need to know about what this guy's alleging on the strong side before we go to what may mitigate?
Yeah, so we have sexual assault allegations. We have sexual harassment allegations relating to what he deems to be an employment relationship. We have allegations that Sean Combs and his son were involved in a shooting and that he was told to cover up, that helped to cover up that shooting with the police, that he was told to lie to police. We have that he was groomed to engage in intercourse with another man, with other men. We also have these really serious sex trafficking allegations that they were eliciting underage sex workers, bring them across state lines, and RICO racketeering allegations, which mean in furtherance of a criminal enterprise that relates to drug use and the solicitation of sex workers.
Does he get cover? This is a civil suit. Does he get cover for acknowledging his behavior in criminal activities, or does he say it was all forced?
That's what I found to be so interesting about this. He actually admits in this complaint that he lied to police officers, and he's just saying that he was under the manipulation, the fear of threat and intimidation by Combs. So that's not necessarily enough to save you if there were to be a criminal inquiry down the line.
So it's a risk to out the situation, because now there could be an after effect. He could get a settlement here, or he could go to trial and win this and then wind up having his own legal problems.
A lot of these allegations are criminal in nature, although this is a civil complaint. So presumably, if it were investigated and deemed to have some veracity, there would be more to this.
So, Geragos, there are two areas. The one that I've heard in the reporting or whatever, Combs denies all this. Part of it is, I would never do anything like this to a man. That's not what who I'm attracted to. But then there is the, this is an article of convenience, and you point to a suggestion of a GoFundMe page that was set up by this same accuser now, trying to raise money because Sean Combs wasn't paying him. There was no mention of these allegations, though, when this request was put in at the beginning of the month. Now this comes out. What do you make of that, and how useful is it for Combs?
Well, if you take a look at the face page of this complaint, you'll see that there's a laundry list of people listed, many of which, or most of which, I know and have had interactions with. I will tell you that you combine kind of the shotgun approach, if you will, of the complaint, along with the GoFundMe, the fact that we're now saying, oh yeah, when I talked to the police, I lied. Now I'm waiting until there was a opportunity for me to cash in. I have a motive to cash in, as shown by the GoFundMe. At a certain point, I've heard a lot of people talk about this. Maybe the pendulum has swung too far in this area and needs to kind of center and come back, because at a certain point, there has to be a statute of limitations. This is not murder. There has to be some kind of a way that somebody who is accused, falsely or not, is able to know it in relatively real time so they can construct a defense. Otherwise, what are we dealing with here? I mean, at a certain point, there but for the grace of God walks anybody. Mm.
Look, we're going to see now. Right now, it's just a blanket denial by Combs, and there's certainly a lot of facts to be plumbed. So we will stay on this. Mark Geragos, thank you very much. Always a pleasure. Misty Marris, thank you very much. Sean Combs' current attorney says this. Roll back up so I can read that. never race through what I have to read on television. This is nothing more than a transparent attempt to garner headlines. We have overwhelming, indisputable proof that his claims are complete lies. Remember, that is not what you need to do to defend yourself. So that is another echelon of what they're claiming as confidence. To be able to disprove allegations, that's a very high bar. We will address these outlandish allegations in court and take all appropriate action against those who make them. And also remember the calculation. Combs has got a lot of money. For him to decide not to settle and go to trial, what does that mean about his disposition towards this? 3 minutes, 45 seconds.